Oh, this isn't good. I've had this mower about 7 years, and it looks like I've blown out a wheel bearing. So let's take a better look. This wheel has two bearings. It has an outer and an inner bearing. And there's not much left of the outer bearing. The little steel balls are missing. The bearing, the shell, the case of the bearing is still inside the wheel. But the race is, it's stuck on the axle. So obviously there's been some axle deformation. Let's see if I can just use brute force and pry the bearing race off of the axle. That's not going to work. Let's try these pliers. What has happened is that the material of the axle has been deformed and raised up enough to keep the bearing race from coming off. So let's file down the axle. And in a situation like this, you need to keep the file. You need to keep rotating the file around the axle so as not to accidentally file a flat on the axle, which is very undesirable. This is a 10-inch flat file. Oh, there we go. That's great. Now let's get the inner bearing off of the axle. And this bearing is not in very good shape. So it's going to have to be replaced. So I'm going to use this dial caliper and take some measurements. I need to know how long the axle is, in case I decide to use an aftermarket wheel rather than a factory replacement. That's not right. Let's take another measurement. That's about right. Let's try. Let's go one more time and take a measurement again. I'm going to call that 1 inch, 420 thousandths. So let's use my 1972 Parker Big Red ballpoint and draw the axle. And now let's record the model number so that we can find out what replacement parts are available from the manufacturer. This has been an excellent lawnmower. I've been very happy with it. And in reality, I should have been oiling or greasing the bearings all along to extend their life. Now, I have a good idea what the diameter is of this axle. But I'll confirm this while I have the dial caliper still handy. And as I thought, it is indeed 1/2 of an inch. And I'll measure the ID, the inner diameter of the bearing, just for kicks. I may replace only the bearings. I'm not sure yet. So, let's write down what we learned. 0.500 for the axle diameter. Now let's measure the diameter of the wheel. And it's 8 inches. And once again, let's use the vintage Parker and write down what we've learned. Let's draw the bearing itself. It has an OD, an outer diameter of 1 1/8, and it has a 1/16 inch flange. Should be enough information for now. And my cat has been watching me the whole time. Perhaps he has an interest in lawnmower mechanics. So let's go to the manufacturer's website and see if a replacement wheel or bearings are available. Let's type in my model number. And I'll choose the 2007 model. And there's my lawnmower in all of its glorious parts. I don't see the bearings by themselves. But here's the rear wheel. And it has the bearings already installed. But the wheel is $26. The $26 may not seem like a lot. But let's go to a hardware store website and see if there's an aftermarket wheel available at a lesser price. And I usually read the reviews, and I know that some of the reviews are not real. And they're written by people that are paid to write favorable things about the product. But sometimes you can tell if it's a legitimate review by the things said in the review. So I need an 8-inch wheel. And the hub needs to be less than 1.420. Okay, so a replacement wheel is about $10. Let's see if I can just buy the bearings and keep the wheel that I have. So I need to choose steel ball bearings. There we go. Now I need a bearing that has a flange on it. Yes, a bearing like this. I accidentally clicked the wrong size. I needed to click the one below it. So a bearing is about $10, and I need two of them, so that's $20. An aftermarket wheel is $10. So it made sense financially to go with the aftermarket wheel, the one that costed $10. And before I take the plastic off of the wheel, I do want to check it to make sure it fits my mower okay. So I'll remove just enough plastic so that I can put the wheel on the mower and check it. And already there's a problem. The backside of the wheel is rubbing against the height adjuster. So that's not good. So let's just reverse the wheel and see how that looks. And that's a lot better. But I don't like this. There's more back and forth motion than what I'm comfortable with. You see that? That's too much. So I need to put a half inch washer on there to take up some of that slack. But I don't have any. So for right now, as a temporary fix, I'm just going to use this. And you remember that, right? The piece of the bearing that we had such a hard time getting off of the axle. Now it's a little bit too thick. So why don't we just saw it into two pieces? So I have it in a vise. And let's saw. Now the saw cut isn't perfectly straight, so I need to square up the spacer. I'll use my bench grinder. I'll just touch the face of the spacer to the wheel, rotating the spacer as I go. As you can see, my wheel needs to be dressed, which basically means cleaned of deposits and smoothed out nice and square. But today is not the day for that. You can feel the heat building in the spacer. And that's not too bad. I'll just touch the wheel to slow it down. Always remember to unplug your tools. Okay, let's slide it on. And that's what I was afraid of. The spacer is still too thick. We want the nut to bottom out on the shoulder of the axle, not the spacer. But I'm going to keep the wheel, so let's go ahead and unwrap it. Eventually, I will get a proper size spacer or the proper size washer. But for right now, I'll go ahead and use the spacer that we just made. I'll just have to be careful not to over-tighten this nut, because doing so may damage the bearing that's in the wheel. So I definitely do not want to damage my new wheel. It's a little too tight. I need to loosen it just a little. That's pretty good. Anyhow, that's all there is to it. Anyone can do it. There's my mower. It's been a great mower. Jeez. Then, sad to say, there's my cat. I'll eventually replace all of the wheels, probably. I'm not sure. But I want to take this time to thank all of you that subscribe to my channel. I'm blown away by the fact that so many of you like to watch me tinker around with my pens and lawnmower and bicycle and stuff. And I appreciate it. So, thanks for watching.